गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास। टुडेज टॉपिक इज वर्किंग विद क्वेरीज। क्वेरीज, अ क्वेरी इज अ डेटाबेस ऑब्जेक्ट, दिस वी ऑल नो, दैट अलाउज टू रिट्रीव इंफॉर्मेशन। दैट मीन्स वी कैन टेक आउट इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम आवर डेटा सोर्स फ्रॉम वन और मोर डेटाबेस टेबल दैट मीट a specific condition or criteria specified by you. For example, if I want to know how many of the student had got more than 80% or how many are below 80%, so this is known as query and this can be done through criteria. The information retrieved on the basis of specified criteria in the query is stored in a separate table called query table. Types of queries. But before knowing about type of query, I am on page number 42. Here query is given. A query is a simple question that you ask to find a specific information from database. You can use query to view, change, summarize, and analyze the specified data in different ways. Let us understand the concept of query with the help of the given example. In your book, they have given an example here. In the student table, you have records of class 8 as well as class 9. Suppose you want to extract the record of students of class 8th and 9th who reside in Panchkula and Chandigarh. You can find this with the help of queries. You can see there are 5 students here, and out of these 5, you may know how many of them reside at Panchkula and how many of them reside at Chandigarh. Queries are made on tables. That means we can use one or two tables for queries, and the result are displayed in the form of table, and the result will also be in the form of a table. Types of queries. Different types of queries are there in Access. Select query, parameter query, action query, cross tab query, and SQL query. Select query. Select query retrieves data from one or more tables and displays the record set in a database data sheet. You can also use select query to group the data and calculate the sum, count, the average, and other type of total. Parameter query. A parameter query is a type of select query that prompts you for input before it runs. That means you have to give a input, like if you want only class 8 student to be displayed, or only class 9 student to be displayed, or student who got more than 80 marks. This all can be in parameter query. The query then use your input as criteria, then controls the result. For example, you can design it to prompt for two dates. If you want to know how many students got enrolled on 15th and 16th, this you can know through your parameter query. Access will then retrieve all data with values between the two specified dates. Then comes action query. An action query creates a new table or alters your data or database by adding, deleting, updating, and appending data to it. Then cross table query. A cross table query uses row and column heading so that you can see your data in terms of two categories at once. Then we have SQL query. this SQL query is also used on tables. Now next, is setting a relationship between tables. For making relationships, you know that primary key, we may use primary key. A relationship works by matching a field with the same name in both the tables. In most cases, the matching field are a primary key from one table that uniquely identify each record in a table, and a foreign key in another table. Now, you can see a table here, but for making relations, we need two tables. So I will be creating one more table here. Create table and go to design, and this is table 2. Okay, here also we need a common field, and in table 1 you already know, notice that roll number was with this roll number we can make a common field. So I will be taking a roll number here instead of ID. I'm taking roll. Then let's take percentage PER percentage, and this percentage can be a number, and then grade can be short text. Now let's put data in it. You can see I have filled this information here. In this we have roll number, percentage and grade. Now let's make relationship between these two tables. Go on database table, go on relationship, under relationship group, and it will ask relationships in which table you want to make. You can make queries also or both. So let's take query also, and here table add. So you can see table 1 is added here, and table 2 also, add table 2 here. Close. Now you can make relationship between here, this roll number to this roll number, and it will ask you which common field is there. You should know roll number is there. Click on create, and you can see the relationship is made. Wherever you will take this relationship is there. This is how two tables are connected through a common field, and you can see a key type of thing here, and this is how the relationship is made between these two tables. Now let's do queries. If you want to create a query, this is my table and this is table number 1. Go on create, and design query is there. You can see this box is there. This is query. Query has two boxes. One is known as object relationship pane. This is object relationship pane, and this is design grid. So under design grid, we have fields, table, short, show, and criteria or. These are the fields which are in our query table. And this criteria, it contains the condition on the basis of which the records will be filtered in the query table. And or, this or is used, this property is used to set multiple criteria in a query. Let's see how this works. If I am taking this table 1 here, add, and close. Now if I have to take all these fields, you can take one field at a time, drag and drop it here. I need all the fields, so I have selected every one of them. Select and put it down. You can see every field is here. and table from which table we have taken, this is written under it. Now you can see which you want to see and which field you don't want to see. Like I want to see roll number, first name and marks. I don't want to see house right now and class. And here criteria is I want to know how many student got more than 90. So you can see the result over here. Go on run. As soon as you click on run, the names and the marks are here and rest of the fields are not displayed here. Likewise, you can do next query on the same table. Select your table. Now, if I want to know how many students are of greenhouse, so again you go on create, go on query design, go on table 1, add and close this, select the table, drop them down here, and I just want to know how many are there in greenhouse, so equal to, and I hope we have to give this double quotes green and close this, and rest of the things. Okay, so when I go to run, you can see all the greenhouse students are in front of me. This was query 3. Likewise, you can do more queries on this. Let's see if I have a different query of two tables. And if I want to merge these two tables, like I want to have roll number, first name, marks, class, house, percentage, and grade. So we can drop these two tables down. Great. And now we can have all these fields in one single table. Go on run. So you can see a percentage and grade. This is how a query can be done. That's all for today. Thank you, class.